that we always have in our minds. Statements that are like, when you get up very early in the morning or in the evening when before going to bed, you make some statements to yourself, believing it, I can do it. I am able to do it. I am rich. I am a successful person. I am worthy. Those are such statements we should make.
Continue with the 8 habits of successful leaders, successful entrepreneurs. And among us, we have the media, and we know how powerful the media is. We know the people the media has uplifted. So I will encourage you to always do journaling. Journaling is when you get up in the morning, write your ideas, write your feelings, write your plans, write your objectives, plan your week, plan your month, and write it down. Don't only wish and wish and think that it will come to happen. If we all know what writing has done, then we should be encouraged to write. So as a good entrepreneur, you always have to write your ideas in the mornings and in the evening. And the second thing, and the most important, that is recommended for all of us entrepreneurs, is exercise. It is recommended that everybody does exercise at least 3 times a week. And biologists who are here will confirm with me that the excretory organ, which is the kidney, if you exercise for long, your skin will excrete the waste product from the things that you have been eating, and you will have less health problems. And I think that the only solution is that do it, try. The first 1 month that you begin doing exercise, something will tell you that no, don't do it, it's dangerous. Why are you doing it? Are you a student? Do it. So we encourage all present here to do exercise. And the next recommendation of the next step in the habits is nutrition. All of us know that in the present century, there is this fast food, and we are encouraged to eat healthy, drink a lot of water, and eat natural foods. We have like parched corn, we have like on polished rice, and those natural foods. Let's not go for food that is not healthy. And if we practice all of this, we are building our own company before we can take off with the business idea. So, Fidelis.
Chotindo Fidelis is my name. I will talk briefly on 3 items. And the first one is well surrounded. The second one is goal setting. And the third one is life planning. The first one, well surrounded here, we're simply saying that if you are going to become a good entrepreneur in your society, you must look up at those people you consider have succeeded in life. People who are seen forward, people who can encourage you to become what you want. If, for example, you are in the quarters, and then you go and select your friends who are those people who would like to go out with you and smoke, what do you think you are going to get in the future? You will turn up to go out to smoke with such people. So you must select in the committee the people that you like, the people that can encourage you to attain your goal one day. And we will add here that while in the quarters, please see good in everybody that you come in contact with. Speak good of people. Then only see the bad side of people. Do good. Those are the few things you should be able to do in your community to be able to interact well with your people. Now, I'll come back now to the second point, which is goal setting. In goal setting, we are told that you must be smart. Smart is S-M-A-R-T. That is the smart I mean. The first letter of smart, which is S. S stands for specific. You must set a specific goal for whatever thing you want to do. You're not going to do everything in life. You get what you want to do. That is your goal. and you, that must be specific. Then we come back, the second letter is M. Letter M stands for measurable. You should be able to measure and be sure that whatever thing you are deciding to do is going to give you profits. Nobody is going out of business to lose. So you must be sure that whatever thing you are deciding to do is going to give you some profits. Then we come back to A. Your goal must be attainable. What do we mean by that? You should be able to do some studies and be able to know that you are going to do whatever thing you are going to plan to do. You may look at something, it is good, yes, but you may not have the means or you may not have the possibility of attending that goal. So you must be sure that it is attainable. Your goal is attainable. The next thing is R. R stands for relevant. Is what you are going to do relevant? Does it have something to do with the community? Are the community people going to use your project? Or are they going to use your project for any business you are doing to be able to assist and you are going to make profit? So, if not, then it is not going to be a good project. You must do that. And then we come to letter T. T is timely. Your project must be timely, as you have heard with other speakers. You don't say that, okay, I'm going to do this day at this time, and then on that day, you are doing nothing. Or you say that, okay, there's a manifest this way. The last one is time, planning, life planning, as I said. In life planning, I have just a sentence there. The entrepreneur who does not plan is planning to fail. Thank you.
Thank you, ladies. We have seen already now. I will still highlight again two things from here, goal setting and self-discipline, which are also very important. The next step for an entrepreneur after having all these habits is that if your plan is to become the president of Cameroon, write it down. Don't begin to bother about how it will start or how it will happen. If your plan is to own the biggest company in Touba, write it down. If you have done all these 8 habits, there is some God that will come through some way and make your plan to come to materialize. And after we have built ourselves in this way, we brought in the business idea. Unfortunately, among us, we have Golov, who is an entrepreneur in the program and is also a businessman and CEO of Horizon Enterprise.
My name is Golov Kongli, a businessman. I come in with business idea. Setting a business idea is very, very important when you sit down to think of doing business. You must sit down and be specific on what business you want to do. After you finish thinking of what business you want to do, you must, first of all, nurse some passion. Passion means desire. You must nurse desire for any business you want to do before you can succeed. Like, for example, some people know, at the corners, when I stood at the corners, I realized that people were standing by the roadside to buy bread, waiting for vehicles to come from town. I decided to draw a program, because drawing a business program, you must first see whether it is the need of the people or a solution to people's problems. And when I practiced that, I opened a bakery. I realized that my bakery was a need in the society, and it was solving people's problems by not standing at the roadside waiting for bread to come far away from town. That is how my bakery is running successfully. The important part of having a business idea is passion, as I have said. You must have passion for what you want. What does it mean, by business people. Anybody can make a business idea, because if you see a need in your society, people's need in the society is already an idea. If you know the idea, to implement it, you don't need to must be the leader. By saying that you are the one who brought up this idea, you must be leading, you must be a leader. You form friends. When you people sit, listen to them. Learn to listen. Don't talk much. From there, you people can come up on how to develop the idea you have next. And one of the important things you can do to succeed is also how you plan the business. My next colleague will tell you people how they plan a business. And you must be passionate and specific when doing the planification. Because if you don't plan, if you don't specify a route to choose before you move, every route will take you everywhere.
Thank you very much once again. I think that Touba can be the best town in Cameroon. Do you believe? We are 12 like the apostles, and we are the multimillionaires here in Touba. And God Love has just talked about the business idea, how he's putting the business. I will link it again to good surrounding. Most of the petty business people at Four Corners, when you meet them, they will just say, oh, business is failing because I don't trust anybody. I'll bring somebody who will steal my money. So there is an African proverb which is coming from us that if you want to go far, you go together. If you want to go fast, go alone. So Adamu will tell us what we can do to take the millions that we want to take and bring here to Touba.
Thank you once more. My name is Muhammadu Adamu. So as my colleague here rightly said, he talked about ideas generation. And before you generate an idea, you have to think about this aspect, which is how to develop a successful business model. So this brings us to the concept of teamwork. No matter how strong a business idea is, you will never succeed when you are alone. So don't be alone, but rather look for your team. That is why entrepreneurs all over the world sat and brought about a concept which they termed in their own words, Trinity of Management. And by way of definition, Trinity of Management, simply put, is a summarized concept of business model that helps you go across your business ideas. So this embodies three broad domains, which are the domains of production, the domains of market, and the financial management domain. And in the domain of production, we are going to talk about the producer, who is the first person people always think that they are the owners of business, but it's not like that. You can be a producer when you are not the owner of the business. And in this production, it can be a producer, others might call it a manufacturer, but be it what name, it should be a person that is able to answer the three strong economic questions on production, which are the questions of what to produce, how to produce, and for whom to produce. When that is done, I think that section has been targeted. So the second is being the market, which will be the marketer here. The marketer is a person who will play the gymnastics to know the various channels that the goods produced will reach the potential customers. And also, he will also be the person to know which type of models, which types of tactics he will use to advertise the product. So once you do this again, that place has go alone, but rather if you want to go far, go together.
So we have the intellectual mind. Like as I'm talking that your intellectual mind is working. But there's another area which is more sometimes very important and neglected, which is emotional. The most important example, when we were coming here for this occasion, we heard it was a graduational ceremony. And we're looking what we can put on. And we're looking the kind of design we can wear so that we took the occasion. And maybe we visited some designer shops and before we came here. So effective communication, you must communicate the emotion of the person. Let me take for example that I was in a shop now and a customer had just come in to get something for this occasion. And he wants to get something for the occasion. Maybe they don't know what to have to take. But I will make a choice for him. I said, oh sir, where are you going to? He said, I'm going for graduation ceremony. Oh, this suit will be good for you. Yes, when the person chooses a suit, I will make a choice for the person. I will propose for him. What kind of occasion, what kind of suit do you want? And I will select for him. And even when he's taking it, I can say, okay, now this time, this shoe also is good. Now this time you are speaking out to the emotion of that person. And secondly, again, as you have got to that business, how can you communicate the business to other people to know that you have a business? If your business is here in Tubac, do you only want Tubac people to buy, or you want other people to buy? Sometimes we can also use medium of social media to communicate our business. And in this place, there are some things you need to do when you want to communicate your business. Yes, we have our brother here as an artist, he's a part of the panel as I heard, read. You are doing artist group, but how can somebody in America know that you are an artist? You need to communicate it. How can we use this communication method? Use the social media. We have Facebook, we have website, make a website, create a website. Like for instance, our expertise that is here, it was through social media that Toby Vision was communicated. He saw Toby Vision and he took advantage of Toby Vision because of the social media. And today, Toby Vision has never, Cornelius with the director has never been to Colombia. But the Colombia is here today because of what? Communicate, effective communication. Sometimes we use our own medium of communication, not the right way. But I'm talking here about effective communication, which I will be rounding up to talk about some points here, which is EIDA. This EIDA is A-I-T-A, which I want to talk something concerning it. The A then stands for attention. When you are making your communication, maybe by social media, or maybe you want to make advertisement of your business, make sure that you create the attention of the person. Wow, there's a good design shop here, and there are good stock in like December is coming, there are good stock. I've just gone for Dubai, there are good things there, and for affordable prices. Let it cut the attention of the person. Secondly, we talk about let it be interesting. I understand for interesting. Make it interesting. Oh, it is wonderful. The shop has just come, it is new in town. Like now what we are seeing here, what we are doing here, we are new millionaires in Tuba, in the very shop world. Make it interesting, let it cut the attention, let it be interesting to somebody. And we go now to D, which is talk about desire. Let it be desirable. Oh, this designing, they are good, they are wonderful. In fact, if you put it on and go to that occasion, everybody will be looking on you, will be wow. I mean, when the person has the desire, you are only catching the person close to you. And the last point now that we'll be talking is action. Let the person take action. Give a communication that the person will do what? Take action.
From the team, I will go now to see customers. Most people, sometimes they don't care. They just say something to the customer. They don't mind about the customer. I think I will share an experience. In the course, we learned that a child laughs 400 times and an adult laughs only 15 times. You know what laughter can do. I was owing some money and I was going to the person. I was afraid that he would not give me the goods because I am owing so much money. But when I went, I started laughing and he was smiling. When I said, can you give me the goods? He said, yes, yes, but you know you are owing me the money. So it means in customer experience, we should do things as entrepreneurs to make the customer to be satisfied. Because the money is with the customers. The money is in their pockets. If you don't make them to be happy, then they cannot remove the money. So make an experience that when you bring something, at least the customer can say, voila, wow, it's okay, and be happy. So Maxwell will continue.
My name is Atana Maxwell, and I will be talking on the four basic, most important key skills that after you have acquired all of this knowledge about entrepreneurship, you must put in place to be successful. And these four basic skills are indispensable when talking about entrepreneurship. And they are, we have research, we have public speaking, we have public speaking, we have socialization, and to end it, we have technical knowledge. To begin with the first one, which is research. Research is all about findings. Are you talking to financial institutions? You must be able to communicate what you need before they can understand you. And the third one is socialization. When we talk of socialization, we mean now how you interact with other people. If you are an entrepreneur, you must be able to have fun. You must be able to interact with people. Don't limit yourself or don't see yourself as a big person and avoid other people because you see them as small or as not as the same as you are. So you must be a social person who interacts with people and you discuss your business ideas. And we'll finish by looking at technical knowledge. When we talk of technical knowledge, we go to the social media. As we heard from one of my colleagues, he was talking about the social media where you communicate with other customers